Hey guys, it's Tony with Wandering Wiener Antiques again. And there were no garage sales this weekend. It rained all last night and all this morning and into the afternoon, so there was nothing going on. However, I did stumble across a listing on Facebook Marketplace for a box of jewelry. And it's a pretty small box. You can see it's not a lot. But the pictures that I saw, preview pictures that I saw, were pretty good. There were some Victorian things in there. I'm hoping for some gold. It looked like some cameos and stuff that might be gold. So luckily we had that on Facebook to go through, and that'll make up for some lost garage sales this weekend. But let's dig through it and see what we can find. All right, so here is our box of jewelry. Again, found this on Facebook Marketplace yesterday, and I went to go pick that up after work, and we're going to dig through it today. First thing is this very 60s, 70s brooch. Looks like maybe a Christmas item. That's kind of neat. As always, things are pretty tangled. Always takes a while to get through some of this sometimes. That is an interesting retro necklace. Got a mark on it. Let's see what this one is. Costume, I assume. Sarah Coventry. It's a big mess is what it is. I was hoping that would come right out, but a lot of times, if you can, undo the big one here. That's pretty ugly, but somebody will like it. A lot of times if you undo each necklace, if you can find the clasp, then it makes it much easier to untangle, obviously. Another rhinestone necklace. Nothing too exciting on that. I love buying these boxes with all these chains because you never know what they might turn into. Most of them are Avon or some other costume, but every once in a while you run into a gold one if you can untangle them. There is a weird spoon locket. And costume cameo. There's nothing marked on that. I did see this piece in the preview pictures. That is a big, probably about an inch and a half, rhinestone brooch. And it does have a mark on it. That's a Sarah Coventry as well. So right off the bat, a couple of pretty decent costume pieces. Couple of Sarah Coventry rhinestone pieces, and move over because there's a cow brooch. That's pretty exciting. That is marked, nothing fancy. That's probably from the 80s. This definitely looks old. Looks like back of a pocket watch, maybe, or a locket. It's kind of big for a locket, but nice Victorian bird design on that with some sort of stones in there. I don't know if that's glass or what that is, but there's no marking on that. I don't believe that to be gold. There's a nice poodle brooch. People collect all sorts of animal brooches, and the poodle people are pretty nuts over those. That's a Kramer, so that's a decent brand for a costume. And one of these newer bracelets that you can put together. My mom used to like those. There's a watch that looks kind of old, but I think it's just styled to be that way. I don't recognize that brand. Looks pretty new. And this is one of the pieces that I saw in the preview video. That is an old Cameo, probably 1900, 1910, somewhere in there. And you can see through, if you can see through the light. Oh, and actually, looks like somebody inscribed a name or initials or a date. I'll have to get that in better light, but you can kind of see it maybe. I don't know if the camera's picking that up, but there's an inscription on the back of that Cameo. Get back to this mess over here, or maybe we should just save most of this for later. Off camera, it doesn't look like there's anything terribly fancy or valuable in here. Maybe if I can just lift this out without making too much of a mess, I can look at that off camera and we'll go through that later. Here's another nice rhinestone earring, clip-on earring. Hopefully there's a match in here somewhere. Those chains look pretty good, but there's a nice brooch as well. Fairly classy looking design. Let's see if that has a mark on it anywhere. Doesn't look like it. And I also saw this in the preview pictures, another Cameo. Probably from the same era, 1900-ish. And this one's nice because it is a brooch and a pendant you can wear on this chain. So let's see if this one is any better than that first one that didn't have a mark on it. And it is. That one says 14 karat Italy. And so what about this chain? Yeah, 14 karat gold as well, so nice vintage Cameo necklace pendant find right there. It's got the little, probably a little diamond chip around her neck as well. So that is a nice find. That's the main one that I saw in this preview that I wanted to check out because it looked like it was probably good. Another clip-on earring, probably from the 60s. Set all the earrings aside and hopefully have a few matches. And here is the other side to that Victorian, I'm gonna guess a locket. Unfortunately, it's pretty beat up, but somebody I think could probably put that back together. And I don't see a mark on it, unfortunately. But I'll look a little closer off camera. We'll see. But it's nice to have the matching piece to that. Another older costume earring. I think we're going to have quite a few of those. That looks like it came off of a necklace, but it is marked something. Sarah Coventry. So that's just parts. But we might find the rest of it. More earrings. More clip-on. More costume. Another Sarah Coventry. Another tangled mess. Boy. Not sure we're going to get that one apart too easily. Looking for the clasp on that. Here we go. I think I lost the pendant on that one. Nope, I did not. It's right there. That is a little tiny little baby shoe with a stone in it. Doesn't look like that's marked. Here's, I assume, a necklace that is tangled but turns into a peacock. I'll have to try to untangle that one again later. And we got some nothing plastic beads. That's not exciting. It's a pocket watch that is pretty new. Legant, or most likely Le Crap. That chain looks a little older though. Probably have to take that chain off the watch. And another little rhinestone earring. Plastic bead necklace, nothing exciting there. Here is an older women's watch. Let's see what this is about. Hillbros? I don't know how you pronounce that. Base metal, so nothing too exciting there. Got this giant plastic necklace that's pretty ugly and pretty tangled. Here we go. Sort of looks like Bakelite, but I don't think it is. I think that's just plain old plastic. But I'll double check that as well here in a bit. Here's a giant, ugly brooch, probably from the 60s, maybe 50s, maybe 70s. I don't know. Sometimes they all kind of look similar to me, at least. But it's Sarah Coventry, so another marked. And there's another poodle brooch. This one has a mark on it too. Sarah Coventry on that poodle, so I'm gonna have a decent poodle collection here in a bit. And that's another nice, looks like complete rhinestone brooch. And don't see a mark on that one anywhere. This piece I saw on the preview as well. Another piece of a locket, unfortunately. It's busted, but it says Mamie engraved on the front. I don't see any markings on that to indicate it would be gold or anything like that. There is a little locket charm bracelet necklace type thing. I guess it's a necklace with that long of a chain. I think that one's fairly new, nothing exciting there. It's another costume brooch, cameo brooch. Nothing exciting, but people do like the fake brooches as well, or I'm sorry, the fake cameos. That necklace goes with that earring. We'll see if I have the other earring in here somewhere. Here's another giant, ugly costume piece, probably from the 70s or 80s. Pair of earrings already pre-packaged for us. Another, that's an earring. I thought it was a brooch because it's huge. But I guess some people like those big pieces on their ears. Another rhinestone earring. Here is another faux pearl brooch. Don't see any markings on that one. See, that's an earring. I think I had another piece to that somewhere. I thought I saw it. Oh, yep. Right here. So I got one matching pair out of this box so far. And there's the other match to that earring set. That's another pendant costume piece. Don't see any markings there. Let's see. That is a gold colored necklace. I don't think that one is real. A lot of times you can tell because if they were real diamonds or something like that, they would have holes in the back to let the light shine through, and obviously that one does not have that, unfortunately. Got quite a few little stick pins in here, hat pins. Nice butterfly and a flower. Let's go through a couple of those real quick. Another faux pearl. And a turtle, it looks like. Don't believe any of these are marked. Let's see one more here. That's a frog. Nothing marked on that one. And that is another big, nice rhinestone brooch that has all of its stones in it. Let's see if that has a mark on it. Don't think so. I also saw this piece on the preview video, which is a very nice Victorian locket from the late 1800s. Most of these are probably gold filled, but we're gonna see if we can open this up real quick without taking too long. I assume it's a locket, but maybe it's not. It looks like it comes apart. But I don't see where it would open. But either way, that's a nice piece of Victorian jewelry right there. Hopefully the detail is coming through. Let's see. There is another rhinestone to match that earring, so we got another set there. Let's see, there's a blue one, which I'm betting matches that big brooch. Let's see, there's that match. There we go, we got matching earrings. And if I can get it on screen, the necklace to go with it. There is a nice little pendant. Looks like a piece of glass or maybe a garnet. Let's see if that thing's marked. It's pretty heavy if it is. It is not marked. Costume. So obviously glass. There's a really ugly cufflink. I don't think the match is in here. It's probably a good thing because that thing is hideous. Another costume cameo locket. And we're getting down to the bottom here. Never know about these earrings. We'll see if that's marked anything. Napier. Nothing too exciting. Every once in a while, there's the match to it, by the way. Every once in a while, you get lucky and those are gold. And here's another heart locket. And that's an older one. Looks like it has the initial M on it. It's always kind of sad when they still have pictures in there. Never know who these loved ones are. And they end up in garage sales or flea markets or somewhere where nobody seems to care who they are. I think that one's probably gold filled. There's no mark on that. Junk ring. Looks like a Christmas wreath. Pendant, brooch, I'm sorry. There's a pair of ugly earrings. Looks like some of this is all from the 80s. Like playing the matching game when you were a kid. Let's see, this is junk, it looks like. Tangled junk. And hitting the bottom of the barrel here with a couple little earrings and miscellaneous things. I don't think there's any. Oh, what's this? Hang on. This is a heart bracelet, if you can see the hearts there. But it looks pretty nice. See if it's got a mark anywhere. And it does, 14 karat. That's probably right around a gram, maybe. So that's the second piece of gold out of this box. Actually, third, because we did have the cameo and the necklace that went with it. And I think the rest of this is just a little bit of miscellaneous earrings and other missed match items. There's another pair of earrings. So yeah, thanks for watching the video with me and for watching me find that gem out of this box. 14 karat gold vintage cameo pendant brooch. Pretty sweet. Anyway, thanks for watching and be sure to check out my channel and subscribe, hit the bell to be notified when I upload new ones, and follow me on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, all the usual social media outlets. And we will see you next time from Wandering Wiener Antiques.